Hello students.
Hello sir.
Today to start with our conversation, I have a question for all of you. You must have charged your mobile phones, but charging of mobile phones require a DC signal. Why you put them in AC socket signal? Then you must face a problem. Why don't you face any problem?
Sir, maybe the current gets changed.
No sir. I think a device have been used which converts AC into DC.
Correct. So, this is our topic today. There is a device which converts AC into DC. This device is known as a rectifier and the process is known as rectification. And we use a PN junction diode for rectifying AC into DC because of its property that PN junction diode conducts only in one direction. Here on this computer screen, there is a general layout of a rectifier. So, you have seen a general image of a rectifier. But do you know that rectifiers are of two types? Look at computer screen, half wave rectifier and full wave rectifier. Now let us start our conversation with half wave rectifier. Here is the circuit representing half wave rectifier. I think you all are familiar with the different elements of this circuit. So tell me Hitendra, what is this?
Sir, this symbol is generally used to represent alternating current source.
Yes, you are right. Now Simran, will you please tell us what is this?
Sir, this is a PN junction diode.
Yes, Simran, very well said. Now Soumya, you tell me what is enclosed here in the dotted lines.
Sir, this is a transformer. But sir, what is the need of a transformer here?
The AC signal in our homes range from 220 volt to 240 volt. Transformer steps up or step down the voltage so that the required level is achieved for our appliances. Look at this element. This is load resistance and the output is taken across this load resistance. So, mobile chargers and chargers of other appliances consists of transformer, diode and load resistance. For better understanding of its working, look at computer screen. When AC supply is switched on, let us consider that during the first half of input AC voltage, the terminal A is at higher potential and terminal B at lower potential, and correspondingly terminal C and D are at higher and lower potentials respectively. Now in this case the diode is forward biased, hence it conducts and there is a current through the load resistor RL and we get an output voltage. Now during the negative half cycle of the input voltage, the terminal A and C are at low potential. The diode is now reverse biased and it doesn't conduct and no output voltage is obtained.
But sir, as we have read in the earlier classes that in the reverse biasing also, there is a small amount of current present in the circuit.
Yes.
Then why don't it conduct here?
Because the reverse saturation current of a diode is negligible and it can be considered to be zero for all practical purposes. Now we leave up theoretical part and come to an experimental setup. For that, I have prepared a circuit for you. Will you help me in identifying its components?
Sir, here you have used a transformer. Yes. Which is stepping down the voltage.
Good.
And then sir, it is connected to the diode and the load resistance.
Yes.
And sir, here the indicator is used to show the continuity of the circuit.
So, if the circuit is continuous one, then this bulb will glow.
Yes sir.
Okay. And here we are using a diode.
Yes sir.
Earlier we have discussed that we can rectify AC signal into DC using a diode. Okay. So, here we have a circuit where there is a diode.
Yes.
Now, after applying input AC wave, can we have DC wave? According to our earlier study, we should have.
Yes sir.
To observe it, we can use an oscilloscope. And there is an oscilloscope. Hitendra, will you pass on that oscilloscope to me?
Yes, sir.
So, students, I have made primary connections of a half-wave rectifier for you with this oscilloscope. Hitendra, please come this side to have a look at oscilloscope screen. So, you are observing that there are two lines. One is red one, the other one is yellow one. These two are corresponding to two signals. These are base lines. Now, we would like to see what type of input waveform we are giving to the diode and then what type of output waveform we are gating. For that, will you help me in connecting this lead to the input of the diode? Okay, so you are observing a waveform. This is a sinusoidal waveform. This is the input waveform we are applying at the input of the diode. Since we have discussed, this is a half wave rectifier. Now, we would like to see what type of output waveform we are getting. For that, Simran, please, will you make connections? You take output of this diode, okay, and make other connection to the output of the resistance. Okay, good. So, now you are seeing a waveform at yellow baseline. This is output waveform of the diode. Can you superimpose these two signals? Right? Yes, yes. Bring this yellow one upside. Try to bring this baseline of yellow at the middle of the red. Okay, very good, very good, very good. So, you are observing that only half of the input waveform is rectified by the diode and lower half of the input is eliminated. So, students, you have observed a waveform on this oscilloscope using this circuit, and that is half wave rectification. Only half of the input wave is rectified, and that is a disadvantage for us. Rather, we need full wave to be rectified. For that, we use another circuit. I have brought that another circuit for you. Here you are observing, we are using two diodes in place of one in earlier circuit and a transformer. This transformer is different than what we have used in our half wave rectifier. You are observing this transformer, there are three terminals and there is a terminal in between the extreme two. This is called center tapping. Let us look at the full wave rectifier circuit on the screen. Here you are observing that we are using a center taped transformer. The secondary winding of the transformer is center taped to make two circuits. There is one circuit using diode 1, that is D1, and there is another circuit 2 using diode D2. And you are observing that there is a load resistance RL where we can have output of both D1 and D2. For better understanding, we have a presentation. Just look at it. Here, let us see the case of first half wave of input AC voltage, and let A be at higher potential and B be at lower potential. As an effect, C and D be at higher and lower potentials respectively. This causes the diode D1 to be forward biased, hence it conducts. However, at same time, diode D2 will be reverse biased and it behaves like an open circuit. So, circuit 2 behaves like an open circuit, and therefore, the current flows through the load resistor RL, and a positive output across RL is obtained, which will be DC output voltage. Next is the case of second half wave of input voltage. Here, A and C are at lower potentials. The diode D1 gets reverse biased and no current flows through it, and diode D2 gets forward biased, hence it conducts. Thus, the current flows through the load resistor RL and positive output voltage is obtained for the full wave. In both the cases, the current flows from P to Q. The output voltage thus obtained whenever the diode D1 is forward biased, as shown here in this graph. Output voltage where diode D2 is forward biased is shown by this graph. Now, overall output voltage is a combination of both the output voltages and is shown by this graph. So, students, you would have understood it well.
But sir, will the output current always be in the same direction?
Yes, in full wave rectifier, the current will be in the same direction in RL for both the circuits using D1 as well as D2. And we can confirm this using oscilloscope. Let us do it. So, students, we have seen waveforms of a half wave rectifier both for input as well as for output. Now, we would like to see what type of waveforms we have for input and output for a full wave rectifier. For that, I have made again primary connections of this oscilloscope with a full wave rectifier circuit. So, Soumya, please will you help me to connect the input of the diode 1? Okay, So, this is input waveform to this full wave rectifier circuit. Now, you would like to see output waveforms for diode D1 and then for diode D2 and then what is the resultant of these two diodes. So, please Soumya, try to get output waveform of diode D1. Good. So, this is the waveform of D1, output waveform of D1, isn't it? And then take now output of diode D2. So, this is output of diode D2. Red one is output of diode
D1
and yellow one is the output waveform of diode
D2.
Can you superimpose these two? So, that we will have the resultant output of these two diodes. Okay, make baseline same for both the signals. Good, good. So, now you are observing a very good pattern, a very good waveform. This red one is waveform of one diode, output of one diode, while yellow one is output of the other diode. So, this is the resultant waveform of the output of these two diodes, meaning thereby output of a full wave rectifier. Good. So, you are observing here that the negative half of input waveform is converted to positive half, and that is why you are getting the full wave rectified. So, it is an output of full wave rectifier, but this is also pulsating. So, students, you have observed we have positive output voltage even for negative input voltage.
But sir, the current is still varying. It is not a perfect DC.
Yes, because the AC component is overloaded on the output in DC, and that is why we have a pulsating output. For our use, we would like to filter it out, and for that we use filter circuits or smoothing circuits. In these filter circuits, we add either a capacitor across load resistance or a combination of inductor and capacitor for this purpose. Let us see how it happens. As you can see in the circuit, the capacitor gets charged when the voltage keeps on increasing and later it discharges during the decay of current. During this decrease, capacitor provides the current needed to maintain the steady value, that is peak value of current. The output voltage obtained using capacitor input filter is nearer to the peak voltage of rectified voltage. This type of filter is most widely used in power supplies. So, students, before our conversation is over, let us summarize what we have discussed today. So, Simran, from where did we start our conversation?
Sir, we started our conversation with the concept of rectification that takes place through a device called rectifier, which converts AC signal to DC signals.
Oh, yes, absolutely. And Hitendra, what we discussed next?
Sir, then we had a look at half-wave rectifier and its working. We also confirmed the input and output waveforms using oscilloscope.
Yes, and then we discussed another type of rectifier, that is full-wave rectifier. What was our last topic of discussion?
Sir, then we saw that the voltages were still pulsating, so we felt the need of filtering it out.
And Soumya, how it was done?
Sir, it was done with the help of a capacitor connected parallel to the load resistance.
Correct. So, this was all about conversion of AC signal into DC signal. And I think you would now have got the answer of the question with which we started our conversation. What do you say, Simran?
Yes, sir. Mobile chargers have rectifiers in them. But, sir, I was wondering if rectifiers are only used in low voltage appliances?
No, Simran. Rectifiers are used for high voltage appliances as well. So, we conclude our discussion here. I hope you all would have understood what we discussed today. Thank you.